صباح الخير جميعا.
صباح الخير.
محاضرتنا اليوم عن اندومتريوسيس. اندومتريوسيس is a common chronic gynecological condition defined as the presence of functional endometrial glands and stroma-like lesion outside the uterus. It manifests in three ways: superficial or peritoneal disease, ovarian disease, endometrioma, and deep infiltrating endometriosis. Epidemiology. Typically, endometriosis is present mainly in young women, اللي هي between 25 and 29 years, although it is not uncommon among adolescents. And we have 5% that diagnose in postmenopausal women. The risk factors include family history and short menstrual cycle. Racial predisposition remain controversial. The symptoms of endometriosis, mainly infertility. Infertility present in the 30 to 50% of women present with infertility. And pelvic pain include dyspareunia, dysmenorrhea, chronic pelvic pain. The pain is not always cyclic. Unusual symptoms like GIT involvement that include catamenia, diarrhea, rectal bleeding, and constipation. Vesical involvement, urgency, frequency, and hematuria. Thoracic involvement, pleuritic chest pain, pneumothorax, pleural effusion, or cyclic hemoptysis, or asymptomatic, especially if the disease is isolated to peritoneum. Causes of endometriosis. We have many theory for endometriosis. Metastatic theory, transplantation of endometrial cells, the retrograde menstruation, lymphatic or vascular dissemination, iatrogenic implantation with a probable immune hormonal inflammatory mediator. Support this theory is that in up to 90% of women have a bloody peritoneal fluid during perimenstrual period. Metaplastic theory, retroperitoneal deep endometriosis may originate from metaplasia of Müllerian remnant located in rectovaginal septum. And lastly, induction theory, whereby shed endometrium release substance that induce undifferentiated mesenchyme to form endometriotic tissue. Location. The most common location for endometriosis, mainly first the ovaries, pelvic peritoneum, cesarean section scar, deep subperitoneal tissue, gastrointestinal tract, bladder, chest and subcutaneous tissue, and the pouch of Douglas, uterosacral ligament, and torus uterinus, the most common pelvic site of involvement. هنا الصورة توضح لنا most common location of endometriosis as we've seen. In number one, the ovarian endometriosis, and number two, recto cervical endometriosis, here, deep bowel endometriosis, and number four, bladder endometriosis, and five, abdominal wall endometriosis. Radiographic feature. The laparoscopy is considered the gold standard for diagnosis of endometriosis, but also the ultrasound and MRI are increasingly being used, especially to evaluate deep disease. Ultrasound, transabdominal is of limited use. بس يفيدنا بحالة detect large ovarian endometrioma. Transvagina ultrasound has more sensitivity over 90% in detecting deep infiltrating endometriosis as well as assessment of anterior and posterior compartments. If deep infiltrating endometriosis is found, scan should be extended to include assessment of kidneys to rule out hydronephrosis. The transvaginal ultrasound also have benefit to assess the mobility and site-specific tenderness, known as soft markers for endometriosis, which are suggestive of superficial disease and pelvic adhesion. هنا هاي الصورة توضح عندنا في شيء اسمه sliding sign. اللي هو مهم بالاندومتريوسيس اللي هو الميكانيزم مالته شنو بانه put the hand on lower abdomen and try to balloon the uterus between the transvaginally. فنورمالي عندنا the anterior wall of the bowel اللي هو الرectum راح يكون should be slide freely over the posterior aspect of the uterus and cervix. فمن موجودة عندنا هاي السلايدنج أو free sliding, it is called positive sliding sign. And when there is loss of this sliding sign, this In 2000, 2016, the International Deep Endometriosis Analysis Group clearly and systematically outlined the feature of deep infiltrating endometriosis by ultrasound. By ultrasound, first the uterus, we take the shape of a question mark sign. يعني راح يصير إنه هو anti-verted retroflexed uterus مثل ما نشوف بال this transvaginal ultrasound. هاي في حالة severe posterior compartment deep infiltrating endometriosis. When disease affects the ovary, it is called ovarian endometrioma. Typically, picture مالتها راح تكون well-defined cystic, well-defined unilocular cystic lesion اللي هي with internal homogeneous internal echo or what is called ground glass appearance. Maybe a single or multiple and no color flow on Doppler. May have multiple in location and papillary projection. But hi, this is undergo complication during pregnancy, what is called decidualization in pregnancy, and this may be confused with ovarian malignancy. Here, what is called kissing ovaries, when we have bilateral endometrioma that affects the right and both right and left ovaries. So when become enlarged, they become adherent to each other due to adhesion and give this picture by seeing, as we seen here in transvaginal ultrasound, bilateral cystic lesion, which is avascular on color Doppler. Fallopian tube, when affected by endometriosis, hydrosalpinx will result, as we've seen here, by transvaginal. This is a tubular cystic structure that suggests hydrosalpinx, and by MRI, this is dilated structure that suggests left hydrosalpinx. Urinary bladder, when affected by endometriosis, mainly affect the bladder base and the bladder dome more than the extra-abdominal bladder. And the appearance will variable from hypoechoic linear or spherical lesion with or without regular contour involving the muscularis mainly or submucosa of the bladder. As we seen here in this abdominal ultrasound, this is endometriotic infiltration in the bladder wall. And this is also bicolor Doppler. Ureter may appear dilated with deep infiltrating endometriosis. Dilatation of ureter due to endometriosis is caused by structure. إحنا dilatation أما راح يكون بسبب extrinsic compression أو intrinsic infiltration. As we seen here, dilated ureter. And in this picture we have hypoechoic nodule that suggests urethral nodule. Uterosacral ligament, one of the most common location in pelvic endometriosis. We have hypoechoic nodule with regular or irregular margin is seen within peritoneal fat surrounding uterosacral ligament. A lesion may be isolated or part of larger nodule extend into the vagina or into other surrounding structure. And also other feature اللي هي راح تكون thickening of white line of uterosacral ligament more than 5.8 mm. That have association with endometriosis on or near an uterosacral ligament. مثل ما نشوف هنا في هذا transvaginal ultrasound هذا ال white line هذا هو ال uterosacral ligament. نشوف the thickening ونشوف هنا infiltration by this irregular outline hypoechoic nodule اللي هي endometriotic nodule. Rectovaginal septum may be affected by endometriosis. اللي هو راح نشوف نوديول بالترانسفاجينال التراساوند بالركتوفاجينال سبيس بلو لاين باسنج الونج لور بوردر اوف بوستيريال ليب اوف سيرفيس. اند اولسو وي هاف بوستيريال فاجينال وول بوستيريال فاجينال فورنكس ثيكنينج اوف فاجينال وول ديسكريت هايبوكوك نوديول اند فاجينال وول ماي بي هوموجينس اور ان هوموجينس وذ اور وذاوت لارج سيستيك اريا اند ذير مي اور مي نوت بي سيستيك اريا سراوندينج نوديول. هاي هنا الالتراساوند يوضح لنا الاريا اوف بوستيريال فاجينا ذات از انفلتريتد باي ذيس از ريجولار اوتلاين هايبوكوك نوديول. باوتش اوف دوغلاس ذا باوتش اوف دوغلاس از كونسيدر اوبليتريتد مثل ما قلنا اذا سلايدنج ساين از نيجاتيف اللي هو يعني الركتم اند يوترس دونت سلايد ابارت اوبليتريشن كان بي بارشال اور كومبليت. هاي هنا الصور transvaginal ultrasound showing obliteration of pouch of Douglas by this is hypoechoic nodule. endometriotic nodule. Now, MRI has greater specificity for diagnosis of endometrioma, بالإضافة إلى أنه for evaluation of adnexal mass as well as assessment response to medical therapy. So, potentially eliminate the need for follow-up laparoscopy. Superficial endometriosis. Superficial endometriosis أو نسميها Samson syndrome. Superficial هي superficial plaque are scattered across peritoneum, ovary and uterine ligament. بالعادة البيشنت يكون عنده minor symptom and less structural changes in the pelvis. باللابروسكوبية راح تكون تبين as superficial powder burn or gunshot lesion. بالMRI because it is tiny and flat so not visible. But when are exceed 5 mm or appear as hemorrhagic cysts, they appear. This is MRI coronal view showing superficial serosal implants of endometriosis. This is the red arrow. As we seen here in this MRI, T2 will take the high signal intensity that suggests dilated gland, and also by T1 facet T1 high signal intensity suggests hemorrhage. In deep pelvic endometriosis, or what is called Collins syndrome. There is subperitoneal infiltration of endometrial deposit. هنا راح تكون symptom more severe and related to localization and depth of invasion. MRI is used for diagnosis of deep infiltrating endometriotic lesion and for assessment of disease extension preoperative. As we seen here, this is sagittal MRI T2, we see the infiltration of the rectum by this is endometriotic nodule. And also in this picture, we have infiltration of the bladder by endometriosis. Uterus. بالuterus, the most common location that affected by endometriosis, torus uterinus, where the sacrouterine ligament attached, and posterior fornix, the most common location. Clinically, the patient present with dyspareunia. Here, the red arrow suggests the low signal intensity endometriotic nodule mainly at the site of torus uterinus. Vaginal involvement, loss of hypointense signal of posterior vaginal wall on T2, thickening nodule and or mass also potentially seen. And pouch of Douglas, partial to complete obliteration, suspended or lateralized fluid collection. Here in this section of MRI, we have two pathology, vaginal and pouch of Douglas endometriosis. This is the arrow showing high signal foci that suggest vaginal endometriosis affects the posterior vaginal wall. And this is large cystic lesion, high that obliterates the pouch of Douglas. Bowel involvement. Bowel endometriosis affects between 4% and 37% of women with endometriosis. The bowel segment mainly rectosigmoid mainly affects, and oral appendix, cecum, and lastly the distal ileum. Transvaginal ultrasound and then first line investigation in patient with suspected bowel endometriosis. Additionally, the MRI استفاد من نحدد the depth of bowel wall infiltration, the length of affected area, and distance of lesion from anus. مثل ما نشوف هنا بهاي الصورة يوضح هاي infiltration of the rectum by this endometriosis بحيث مسويت لنا narrowing للومن. This is sagittal section and this is coronal view. In this case, we have circular involvement of the rectum by endometriosis. فراح نسوي لنا stenosis بالباول لومن and the patient clinically present with pencil-like stool or constipation. Bladder involvement. The urinary tract is involved in only 4% of women with endometriosis, of which around 90% involve the bladder. هاي هنا توضح لنا infiltration of the bladder by endometriosis. This is low signal intensity nodule that affects the bladder wall. Here also we have bladder endometriosis. This is the nodule by T2 we seen with some high signal intensity inside, suggests dilated endometrial gland. And in T1, FATSAT, the high signal intensity suggests hemorrhage. Adhesion, one of the most common complications of endometriosis is adhesion. بالMRI نشوف as speculated low to intermediate signal intensity stranding on T1 and T2. Adhesion can fixate pelvic organ, lead to posterior displacement of uterus and ovary, elevation of posterior vaginal fornix and angulation of the bowel lobe. وعندنا من one of the most common complications هي يسمونها hydronephrosis. هنا هاي الMRI. The coronal and axial section suggest hydroureter as caused by adhesion of endometriosis. Here also we have adhesion due to bilateral endometrioma that become close to each other. As we seen here, we have T2 high signal intensity due to dilated gland and by FASA T1 high signal intensity due to hemorrhage. Here we have a 30-year-old female complaint of dysmenorrhea and dyspareunia. And by transvaginal ultrasound, we seen two well-defined cystic lesion with internal homogeneous internal low-level echo or ground glass opacity that suggests bilateral endometrioma. Endometrioma, also known as chocolate cyst, اللي هي develop when superficial endometriotic lesion on the surface of ovary invaginate. Blood produced by such implant during each menstrual cycle cannot escape and will accumulate within the ovary, forming cyst that called endometrioma, اللي هي present as complex cystic mass, often thick walled with homogeneous content. هنا مثل ما نشوفها هنا باللابروسكوبي يبين هيك شكلها. And by transvaginal ultrasound, this will define slightly thick wall with homogeneous internal echo. On MRI, the endometrioma may be single or multiple and appear as hyper-intense signal intensity on T1 and FASTSAT T1. And also, FASTSAT يفيدنا حتى to differentiate it from mature cystic teratoma that contain fat. Endometrioma on T2, we have range from having low signal intensity, known as shading, to intermediate or high signal intensity. A low signal intensity reflects hemoconcentration of cyst. Now, بهذا السكشن يوضح لنا low signal intensity wall of the endometrioma. هذا due to caused by hemosiderin. اللي هو نشوفه بال T2. وبالفاتسات T1 يكون له signal intensity wall. وهنا توضح لنا الشيدنج اللي هي most important feature in endometrioma. By FATSAT T1 this appear high signal intensity. But in T2 we have different grades of signal intensity because of different age of blood product. So give this sign that is called shading sign. Abdominal wall endometriosis. Abdominal wall endometriosis is the most common location of extra-pelvic endometriosis and usually occur after cesarean section. بالألتراساوند راح نشوفها مثل ما نشوف هاي الصورة راح تكون well-defined irregular outline hypoechoic nodule with some internal vascularity on color Doppler. But this picture is not specific for abdominal wall endometriosis. Should put list of differential diagnosis like sarcoma, desmoid tumor or metastasis and other non-neoplastic such as hernia, suture granuloma, hematoma or abscess. Clinically, patients present with cyclic pain associated with mens, but patient may also present with continuous pain or no pain at all. And the CT and MRI characteristic of abdominal wall endometriosis are non-specific, both showing solid enhancing mass in abdominal wall. مثل ما نشوف هنا low signal intensity, solid nodule. And this is the MRI sagittal section. showing the signal intensity on comparison with the muscle. By T2, this is red arrow, the endometriotic nodule, will appear iso-intense to adjacent muscle with some high signal intensity that suggests dilated gland. And by T1 facet, they appear slightly higher signal intensity than adjacent muscle. We have what is called chest endometriosis. It will be rare and almost exclusively right-sided. And this develops when we have long-standing pelvic endometriosis. It will be more than 5 years attend endometriosis. Our presentation different as pneumothorax, pleural nodule. مثل ما نشوف هنا هذا chest CT coronal view showing right-sided pneumothorax. And this is MRI, the axial and coronal view, showing this is the arrow showing the pleural nodule that suggests infiltration by endometriosis. Management, medical treatment, mainly hormone regulation that include danazol, a synthetic androgen for suppressed estrogen production, and gonadotropin releasing hormone. Control the menstrual cycle and OCP for suppression of cyclical hemorrhage. Surgical treatment that mainly either laparoscopy or laparotomy. Laparoscopy include ateziolysis, partial cystectomy for resection of anterior cul-de-sac involvement provided urethral reimplantation does not need to be performed, and uterosacral ligament excision اللي هو used in combination with vaginal approach for vaginal disease. واللابراتومي اللي هي هيستيركتومي اند اوفركتومي وتفيدنا في حاله البول انفولفمنت. كومبليكيشن مينلي اللي هي عندنا الانفيرتيليتي مينلي وعندنا اذر كومبليكيشن مالجنت ترانسفورميشن اوف اندومتريوم هاي تكون رير بالعاده less than 1% that usually in the form of either endometrioid carcinoma or less commonly clear cell carcinoma. Differential diagnosis, أهم شيء الإندومتريوم مفرقها عن الديرمويد سيست اللي هو باي فاتسات تي 1 بالديرمويد سيست يصير بيها سيجنال دروب اوت بالفاتسات تي 1 وايل ذا إندومتريوم ريمين هاي سيجنال انتنسيتي. And also other differential hemorrhagic cyst اللي هو راح يجينا بأكيوت سيمتم ويصير بيه regression over time while إندومتريوم rarely present with acute symptom and does not result over time. And last differential diagnosis, ovarian mucinous tumor, اللي هو also have high signal intensity on T1, but less intense than fat or blood. هاي الصورة بس توضح لنا الفرق بين endometrioma ودermoid cyst. اللي هو راح يبين هنا أهم شيء عندنا هذا T1 العادي وهذا الفاتسات. هاي endometrioma بالفاتسات بقت هي high signal intensity. هنا عندنا الديرمويد بالفاتسات صار بيها signal drop out that suggests the content mainly fat. Thank you.